That was fun.
That's pretty awesome.
I learned a lot of things about you. This, you said your best three of your best years of your life when you were in prison.
Oh yeah, I learned a lot. Huh?
You want to see the rest of the stuff?
Well, that's just come on.
No, I'm just offering you want to see it.
But you said it was good.
No, I learned a lot. I learned how to handle people. I learned that being kind to people, you can get a lot more no matter what situation.
And you said that the tattoo was tribal from New Zealand?
Yeah. I'm with the tribe.
I know you got it 3 days before a fight.
Yeah, right?
Definitely. Jeff was coaching you at the time.
Yeah.
He didn't like it too much at the time.
I know.
Shout out to Jeff Fennec. He's the greatest.
Yes, he is.
But don't mind.
I did a lot of things people never did, so.
Yeah. And now everyone knows you. It's iconic, the logo.
But now it's the norm. Everyone has tattoos on their face.
Appreciate you. Thank you.
My brother.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Mike.
Take care, brother.
Always.
Troy. Dre in the house. We're getting like the surgeon shoes on.
Now we out here.
That's a new thing. Have a good one, guys. We'll talk soon. Mike Tyson leaving. Big Youth Podcast.
I had to say Shakur Stevenson. Gotta put him in there. Shakur Stevenson got the best defense in boxing.
T.I., do you box? You train?
Just for cardio. I do train, just for cardio. Yeah,
this is my baby right here.
Hey.
Where's T. Will at?
This is the family.
T. Will, where's the family?
I don't think I'll get that right now.
Come on, ladies.
Family.
These my ladies that produced the show.
How you doing,
guys? How you doing, bro?
They from Jersey too.
Jersey, yeah.
All right, we do
it.
Sorry.
Right outside of
Cleveland.
Yeah.
Come on, y'all.
Come
on, sit down. And they say, "What?"
They say, "We're
going to get the crew, so everybody can
sign." There you go. I'm
gonna get on riff and I'm gonna give it to you so you can, you know.
Thank you, Bobby.
You have water, anything?
Yeah, we got water. Hold
on.
He needs some water. Get the man some water. As a matter of fact, move that water out the way. They be trying to sue us. What camera were you?
Drinking.
Huh? What camera were you?
Matt's back there.
Wow. They ain't gonna be with everybody right here, is
he? Yeah, we're gonna clear it out.
Ooh. My bad, man.
Guys, can we just get this?
Just more on the outside. Because we'll be moving up in the corner. So if you guys are here with it, and just anywhere outside.
Troy in the house. Nice shirt. Oh, it's Mike Tyson wearing a shirt of Mike Tyson.
Shirt of a shirt of a shirt.
Everybody was asking today about the ears.
Mike bites, can't miss them. Sold out in a day.
Sold out in a day. That's crazy.
20 million the first day.
That's incredible.
With,
Can he smoke on this?
Hey, Royce, can he smoke on the
podcast? Yeah.
Yeah, that's for a bad offer.
I tried calling, but it was phone number. Why does he have bags on his shoes?
Mm-hmm. To not dirty them.
Yeah, you're good.
What?
Hey, guys! Hey, Philly,
dude.
We ain't really Philly. You got an ashtray?
We got the ashtray?
Where
was it? It should be right there.
Trip, we'll call you. Just circle around.
Who do you know better than
one? Because after this, it's all real. We don't practice after this. It's camp. Let me see you. Real, huh?
Yeah, my phone got choice on it.
Huh? Oh, yeah. Oh, what was that on it? Okay. Yeah, he hit that motherfucker.
How you doing, man? It's good. It was interesting. So, Mike, you said you had a $3 million fine for the bite?
Yeah, $3 million.
Wow, that's the biggest fine probably in history.
Yeah.
But how much money did you make since then? Because your new edibles are selling.
Listen, I'm going to tell you something that's really funny. And I don't mean it in a bad taste. That's the best thing I ever did, a bite of there.
What's so, going on? What's
hey,
going
not, on? Not from, you know, I wish I been did, but like from a business.
Hey, Mike, go get a picture. Here we out.
All right. Yeah, it was. I had to be miserable first, but then after that, it was all gravy.
Yeah, and now you have edibles. That's interesting. Yeah, it is. $3 million to lose over. You're probably devastated when it happens, right?
No, because I still had 27 left.
Okay.
That was a word. I think want to take a picture with me.
Have you met T.I. before?
I know T.I.
T.I., you know Mike?
We met, yeah, absolutely. That's my guy.
Okay, next time.
Legend,
If he decides to fight again, can you walk him out?
Of course.
What song do you go with?
Be My Honor.
What song do you pick, T.I.?
Bring him out.
I mean, I actually would pick a song called Stand Up. That's what I'd pick.
Yeah. Well, let's get this picture right before we go home.
Yeah. Yeah, Mike, that's man, it's legendary.
Icon.
You dig
know
what I'm saying?
So how do you live in Atlanta with all that distraction?
What do you mean? I was born there. That's caused those distractions.
Yeah, that's distractions, man. I'm
trying
to be a decent
human being.
How do you
think? I mean, you know what I'm saying? This thing, what you do is how you do it. You know what I mean? Hello?
Checking in.
Hey.
Where's the
camera
over here?
No, you got to fix
them. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
he ain't the king no more. Hello.
DJ,
DL,
I thought he looked like Joe Frazier.
Let me do one more.
Young Joe.
1, 2, 3.
Appreciate it. No, we got two that fixed that one for
you. Let me take a picture with both of you guys. Both of you.
You want me to take it?
Sure. Hold on 1 second.
Oh.
Okay. No, what's your camera?
Oh.
I got the old Paul McCall. I went over there and he and I exchanged some harsh words. Well, actually, he wasn't saying shit. It was me. Shit, everybody who spoke, he got something to smoke.
Let me at least hold one. I don't want to smoke shit.
Go ahead,
fire
up. You never had a good time.
Peace out.
Don't cheat.
Don't do that. What do you call Benavidez? The Mexican monster?
Yeah.
You want to see him and Charlo, him and Canelo?
All them motherfuckers, they think they're bad motherfuckers. I want them to fight the Mexican monster. I'm serious though. I'm not smoking, talking shit, I'm serious.
No, I know.
All that testosterone, everybody's talking and shit. He's this Mexican motherfucker that he calls the world out. Shut him up.
All right.
Talking too much shit, shut him up.
Canelo's fighting for the 175 title. against Bivol.
He can get some of that too. Mexican Monster wants him too.
All the guys. By the way, last thing, Mike. How does Francis Ngannou do in boxing if he transitions?
Hey, I think he could do well.
Why?
I think because he's still young and he can still learn.
True? It'll be a big fight.
What's up, Dick? Yeah. We got a good place here, man.
Did you get a tour ready?
Well, I didn't get a tour, but from looking at it, you got these motherfuckers working for you. Once you got a white motherfucker work for you, you made it.
You know you did, huh?
Yeah.
Big U, do you box? Do you box?
Yeah, I
do.
Right here.
There you go. And then
look straight back. I think it's an insult to say that when you say that next to Tyson, I dabbled in. I dabbled in. Right next to Tyson, do you box? Hell no, come here, AJ, come here.
I did with a dabble.
Yeah, he said you.
Take it back. What are you saying, Mike? It looks like a street picture.
Fights up, they look like some street niggas on the corner.
Look at that, Mike.
That's a classic.
Yeah, that's classic.
Let me get one more on my nephew.
Yeah, of course.
The bare knuckle champion.
Bare knuckle champion.
Wobbles on
deck. That's not easy, bare knuckle. There's a guy named Joey Beltran that's also a heavyweight champion.
Yeah.
Did you fight Joey Beltran yet?
Yeah, I beat him twice already.
He's a Beltran, big dude from San Diego.
He beat him already.
I know.
Yeah, I'm the only person to beat him twice.
Congratulations, he's pretty good.
No, he's good.
Introduce him. What's his name?
AJ, that's AJ.
AJ, nice to meet you.
So you only knew his name. We beat him 2 times.
Well, he's my buddy, so.
Tell him he lost 2 times.
I'm Elie. I will. I'll send him the video.
He gets around.
Congratulations on the belt. Nice to meet you, Elie.
Yeah, I took the belt from him.
What? I don't know. When are you fighting next?
May 6th, in Orlando.
Go ahead, Troy.
Hey, only your whole family say you're playing like that. You know how when they don't talk?
What's up, man? Hey, how you doing?
Hello. Meet anywhere? Reporting. Thank you.
Yeah, of course.
Is it a tour of the place, first of all?
Yeah, I don't think so.
Oh, it's a walking shot. Got it.
We're going to back up, guys. So you're welcome.
Ready?
Can you step on this side of the alleyway? And, yeah. Watch your head, Eli.
Yep.
This is great. Come on up, Mike. We're all backing up. Look to the right a little bit. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. You're good.
You're good.
One more time?
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
That's great.
Behind the scenes,
Mike
Tyson.
With my whale.
Catalina whale
bitch. Ready? Yeah, I'm ready.
shit look?
It looks great. Look to the right a little bit. Yeah. Okay, we got that.
Champ,
what's happening? How you doing?
Good to see you.
Man, hey, champ.
You know we everywhere.
Champ, it's Vince's birthday, champ.
Look at that.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what we outside.
What are you doing? I ain't gonna pull Big U is my guy. Man. That's my brother, man.
What
are
you doing out here?
I'm everywhere like broken glass.
This nigga everywhere.
We're gonna get a couple of shots with you by yourself, and then we'll give you, and then you're good to go.
You get to interact with them.
Well, as you know, Mike and yourself, Dre, you kind of take it for granted sometimes because it's what you do. You're around them all the time. Maybe in 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, you're gonna look back and say, "Wow, I can't believe I was there at that moment." But when it happens, you almost feel like it's natural because you guys are around Mike Tyson daily. And yes, every day is exciting and it's amazing. But maybe from the outside, it looks much bigger than what it is. It's still amazing. Don't get me wrong. It's still incredible.
What do you learn from them? Like, what's something big that you've taken
work from ethic, legends? Work ethic. Nobody becomes a legend by not working, not giving up, consistency. And you learn something from every person. You learn how they deal with people. You learn how they handle stress, how they handle pressure. They say pressure busts pipes, but also pressure makes diamonds. So you learn a lot from people who are the best in their field. What got them there? Like, what did you do to be successful? And no one just did it lackadaisical or half-assed. They worked really hard. And it's always great when you could be around greatness because I feel like it rub off or you could learn from just being around them.
What have you learned from Mike?
A lot. I learned that the image is different than the person because the image is one thing, Mike Tyson, but the person is an incredible human being. What have I learned? I learned that he's a really brilliant person. He reads a lot. He's really smart. Like, people may not know how educated he is. What else have I learned? I've learned that if you have small conversations with him, so he'll say something that an hour or two later will make me think, like, wow, he was right. Like, he knew. Like, I was surprised that he talks to you like a regular person. And things like that.
Reporting.
Yes, sir.
Elie Seckbach reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com.
I'm Elie Seckbach reporting.